Now I will use the filler to rub up a little bit, probably from the servus seat or maybe from this part here. The reason that I have slight problems fitting it all together is because I decided to use a servus seat that is slightly longer on one end. I did not realize on time that this seat is a little bit too long, literally a fraction of the millimeter, and will block this part here. So I'll try to peel off a little bit from the seat. If it turns out to be a problem, I'll peel off a little bit from that part. Should literally be just a small fraction of a millimeter. It's much better now. A little bit more. Now it fits almost perfectly. The only problem that I have is that this bolt is slightly too long. Now I'll just clip the tip a little bit, which will have also the benefit of not being that dangerous. I'll just go ahead and slightly cut the tip. Probably enough already. A little bit more. This. Now we seem to have nearly perfect fit. It doesn't seem like it's blocking anywhere. Yeah, I think we're all good now. So that was it. This step was partially not really necessary. It was just due to my decision to use this seat instead of another seat from the set of seats for the servo. So now I can go ahead and move to the next part. So now I'll go ahead and mount this part that I took off earlier. It has to install here. I already peeled off the problem here. So to mount it, we'll insert the longest type of bolts with hexagonal head. It's 10 millimeters. Insert it from the side of the servo through this central hole, loosely, very loosely, put a nut just to stay in place. And now we have to figure out the orientation. Well, it's easy. There is only one way to fit these holes. This will not work since this hole is too big for this peg here. So the only way is this way. We insert the nut here, place this guy here and tighten. Use the hexagonal tool to further tighten it. Do not over tighten. Leave it slightly loose so it can adjust itself once when we mount other parts. So here we go. This part is ready. Now I will go ahead and join these two parts together. In the previous step, I noticed that when fully tightened the bolt, it is a little bit too long and starts pressing against the acrylic piece here. So I decided to go ahead and use filler to take off just a little bit, fraction of a millimeter, at both ends at the tip. This allows me to properly tighten the bolt without deforming the acrylic piece. So now once again, let's see how the two pieces will join together. They should work like this, I believe. Just to confirm, I'll go ahead and take the bottom part again. Let's test it all again in place. This one will be mounted here. This one will go here. And the two of them will be joined like this. So it seems like I have assembled everything correctly up to this point. I'll go ahead, insert bolt from this side, like this. Put a nut very loosely. Insert the nut into this slot here. Make sure the pegs are entering their corresponding holes, and using the hexagonal tool, tighten loosely the bolt. Again, leave everything slightly loose so we can adjust in the future in case some minor adjustments are needed. But this part now appears to be properly mounted. Hopefully, mounting this will not prevent us from mounting the rest of the parts, but we'll see as we progress with the robot. Now I will go ahead and install these two parts here, here and here. The reason I first joined these pieces together is that these two pegs have to go inside these two parts, and if you install these parts first, then it will be difficult to install this part between the two of them. I'll go ahead, take them out. There is a bit of left over here. So now, make sure all of the paper is peeled off. Peel off the paper on the other side. The same with this one. all the paper is removed. And make sure that the bolt can fully insert. I believe that I may need to peel off a little bit at the end again with a filler, but we'll see. I'll go ahead and at least loosely install them for now, and if necessary, after that I will peel off slightly. I will need to get the opposite end to make sure I know how to orient this particular one. As you can see, it is not symmetric. However, these two pegs here are perfectly symmetric. So now I have to figure out these two pegs, whether the small one is on the bottom. And as you can see, the small one is supposed to be on the bottom. So I have to orient this one like this in order to make sure that it will fit on this side. If I install it wrong, then I will not be able to insert it into the bottom hole here. So again, we orient it with a small peg on the bottom, just like this. I'll start with it since it appears to be a bit troublesome. Insert both legs from the outside. Put a nut loosely. Insert like this with a small peg on the bottom. Use the hexagonal tool. To tighten loosely the bolt in place. You can see that the bolt practically touches, though I will not need to peel off this time, but again, it may be a good idea to peel off with a filler just slightly at the top to give a little bit more room for the bolt in case the bolt is slightly longer than 10 millimeters. They have built it with extremely small tolerances. Now insert this peg here, like this. And now this one should be fairly easy to position properly. It does not appear to be this way. So again, oriented with this central peg here, hard from the bottom, and two pegs here. This appears to be the only way to insert it into the holes. This peg inserts here. So it will be like this. Insert the bolt. In this case, I'll insert the nut here into the slot. Insert the bolt into the nut and start tightening. Tighten loosely. Yeah, it will not be necessary to peel off. I think, yeah, the bolts. Now this bolt touches a little bit, I think, the end. Let me see. Yes, it touches slightly the end. So yeah, I will peel off very little right here. On this side seems to be fine, but I probably will just take off a notch on both of them to be on the safe side. So this part appears to be fully assembled. I'll go ahead and clip the tip of this bolt as well, since it tends to touch barely right here. So yeah, there's some small mechanical adjustments that could be made. And then, at later point, I'll go ahead and install this one here, and we'll have all the servos combined. For now, this part is ready. Now I'll go ahead, peel off a little bit for each bolt, and after that we'll move to the next part. Now I will go ahead and mount all of these parts together. Hopefully they will all fit nice, but we'll see. For this we need the base and the two sides of this, well, joint, I guess. Not sure, assembly. Okay, well, we'll call it assembly, of this assembly. So the idea is that we already know the assembly joins like this, but it will join on top of these pegs here. So I'll start by inserting the pegs on this side. Well, I am already facing a problem. There is one extra peg on this side. So what I will need to do is loosen this side here. Insert the pegs here. And then boy, this is a bit tricky. So two pegs here. The bolt inserts here. And the final peg on this side. At the same time, there is also peg on this guy. So it also has to go in place. So now all the pegs, I believe, are properly in place, and all I need to do is tighten the bolt. Now, installing this side should be fairly easy. We orient it with the servo on the outside, like this, and it slides into all the pegs. Start by installing the two bolts from the side of the servo. Installing nuts for them. Sliding the two nuts into their corresponding slots. They should be fairly well loosened. This one is already in place. Now this one as well. You can see, hopefully. Now tightening the bolt a little bit. all the pegs in place. And the same thing here, tighten this bolt, use the hexagonal tool to further tighten it. Now you can go ahead and tighten all the bolts properly. Since we have our assembly in place, it is fairly complex assembly, but it is fully mounted. Now, the reason I wanted to orient the robot properly before I have installed all this is, as you can see, this part is largely blocking the bolt at the center, so it will be difficult once when you have mounted all this to readjust the orientation of the robot. However, from what I see, I think I have assembled all these parts properly. Yes, everything seems to be fitting nicely in place. We'll see you once when we start testing the robot.